great idea, but she doesn't like it.
Well, I think that's a good thing.
Driving over 40 miles today. It's an 18-mile trip towards my destination today, another doctor appointment. Internal medicine or something like that.
Take the next right onto Sherwin Lane.
That's his speciality. It's also my PCP. 18-mile trip. And that's just one way. So I'm going to have to do 18 miles twice.
In a quarter mile, turn right onto Northwest Freeway.
But there's A.B. Stoddard buying into, well, I don't know yet.
I was raised in the Baptist church. And I was a Baptist.
He's got a calm, soothing voice.
But one day, after years of talking with George Foreman, I started to understand where he was coming from. And his doctrine of love, his doctrine of forgiveness. And
he's gonna have to tell them what happened. So, but also he's gonna have to face, you know, some meeting. Maybe it's gonna be in freaking Minnesota or San Francisco or wherever. But they know the story, and they're gonna have to get his side of it. So he will talk eventually.
This was Brian Gain at his opening presser on his philosophy with Bill O'Brien, and this is what Brian Gain had to say about the philosophical alignment between he and BOB.
Questions about what's going on in the football operation. We're always communicating, but that's not with Coach O'Brien. It's with the mathematics, it's with the scouting staff, it's with the football operation, it's with Chris Wilson and our football trainer.
Turn right onto Northwest Freeway.
It's with our strength and conditioning areas. All those areas, communication is critically important for the success of our program.
So that's his philosophy. We heard it time after time after.
Continue on Northwest Freeway for 1.5 miles.
They basically finished each other's sentences. The exact same whenever they talked at the podium.
But I mean, well, they were in alignment. I had forgotten until I heard that question yesterday, and I forgot who asked it. I'd like to give him credit. In the official press release from the Texans, Bill O'Brien.
He was Brian T. Smith.
Yeah, I think it was Brian T. Smith.
That dude will ask the question. I gotta give Brian T. Smith credit. When it comes to ask the question, he'll go up there and ask me.
In the official Texans press release, Bill O'Brien was quoted as saying that Brian Gain was, quote, head and shoulders above
what changed
every other candidate.
What changed? Right. Great question. And I think it was Brian T. If I'm crediting you improperly, just take the credit and run with it. I do it all the time when I don't deserve it.
Bill O'Brien,
yesterday, this is the weirdest thing. I understand why you don't answer a lot of questions, but the way in which he answered questions about Brian, I don't want to say troubling, but somewhat surprising to me. This is Bill O'Brien on the reaction to Brian Gain being fired.
I think anytime, you know, you get news like that right away, it's, you know, that's a tough decision, like I said, for Cal to make. But again, he was very clear with me on what he wanted me to do to improve and his vision for the football team and his vision for the organization. And that's what we're doing now. We're moving forward. We're excited about the future.
Vision. For those of you, it's 29 times. I'm watching the Astros yesterday. I'm saying, I'm going to listen to this thing. I started counting. 29 times Bill O'Brien mentioned the thorough evaluation, vision, and the statement by Cal McNair.
So Bill O'Brien continued, and Mike Meltzer, who you can hear 6-10 right here on Sports Radio 6-10, asked on the radio from John McClain. John McClain said that there was a strained relationship from Brian Gain and Bill O'Brien. I personally don't believe this. I don't believe this. I know McClain's reporting it. I find that very hard to believe, and I personally, in my opinion,
I have no idea what they're talking about.
The young guys are so analytical. I'll walk in the morning at 8 o'clock, and they've been there for an hour, and they've just run a computer program, and they're gauging the sensitivity of our portfolios for a stock market sell-off, interest rate increase, global recession, and what if oil prices top $20 a barrel. So, really great, great, having a diversified, good team, and young, really, really smart people. I am a guy that's always had a daytimer, Franklin daytimer.
In a quarter mile, keep right to stay on Northwest Freeway.
Planning course. Well, in our financial advisory business at RBC, on my team, everything's on the calendar. I have something on the computer. It shows me where everybody is, at what times, who's coming in, and what's going on.
Keep right to stay on Northwest Freeway.
Wall Street Journal had an article. It said the trendy new way to organize your schedule is like a paper planner.
Continue on Northwest Freeway for 3/4 of a mile.
Major stores are giving more shelf space to paper planners. So anyway, if you're stuck in the dark ages on a daytimer, it's kind of like the tides. They get wide thin. Daytimers kind of went away, but they seem to be coming back. How about that? How would you feel if someone made judgments about you based on your face? Maybe folks that lend you money. So that would be frightening to me because I have a face for talk radio. But one of the largest insurance companies in the world is using facial recognition technology on potential customers to figure out their risk. So a lot of the facial recognition that's done is in China. It's done for political purposes to control people, know who they are and where they are. I read an article where someone was wanted by the Chinese government, and they found him in a stadium of 60,000 people because facial recognition technology saw him when they came into the stadium and then it tracked him. So ping AN.
Nope.
Upgrade to option 9.
All right, anytime you add numbers, appreciate the call and congrats on the move from Pasadena to L.
Just now. Mike, what is the difference between the 9/11 responders and our soldiers that do
of course, I'm avoiding the freeways today.
Is passionate because he witnessed 9/11.
If I travel the freeways or the beltway, I'm looking at a 27 to 30 mile trip. One way.
In a mile, turn right onto Bengal Road.
That 27 to 30 mile trip cuts down to 18 miles.
And the other thing that I heard John Stewart say yesterday, there was an interview and he said he agreed with the interviewer who said, well,
besides, I don't like the beltway.
Take the next right onto Bengal Road. Continue for 11 miles.
First time I got on the beltway, I rode that thing for like a few hours before I realized it goes in a complete circle and you can ride it forever. Forever, I mean. And the exits, they weren't close apart. They were, oh goodness, more than 10 miles apart. They didn't have as many exits and access as they do now on the Beltway. I don't even understand it. It's supposed to go in a circle. trucks, when they have poles like that on their truck, they were supposed to put an orange tie or something on it, like a warning sign, so to speak.
Yesterday.
SH-249. What is that? Two wide loads? No, I'm not doing that. They're on the clock. So, I go first. I'm making my own rules. Serious actor. The other one who's always playing Thor, I don't remember his name. Usually I'm real good with that. I'm able to store useless information like the name of actors and their movies and so forth. I can't remember his name. Not all these youngsters. Older ones, yes, but all these new ones. Everybody's stuck on their phone. This lady next to me is driving with a phone in her hand. Do. I woke up late, stayed up late, went to sleep at 2 or at or close to 3. I finally settled in at 2. can't believe I'm coming over 40 miles just so they can fill out five spaces that they overlooked the first time. You would think they would be familiar with filling FLMA paperwork. Signature I'm forging, the initials I would be if I did it myself. So here I go, a 40 mile trip, just about 18 miles twice, going and coming, just so they can fill out some five spaces and put their initial five times, because it's a revise. Instead of having to fill it all, they can just fill out the few spaces that they missed and initial it, since, you know, this is on another date. I'm surprised they didn't ask for a date, too. Usually you got to put the date and initial if you're going to do something like that, but I guess I got technical just only a certain point. I think my exit's two more lights. If I'm correct, we're Veterans Memorial right now. And I know Veterans Memorial goes all the way to Aldi. Or I think it does. I'm not sure. I thought it did.
Turn left at Fallen Creek Drive.
And there you have it. I wonder, can y'all hear my GPS navigations?
Take the next left onto Fallen Creek Drive. 600 feet. Turn right onto Cypress Creek Parkway. Farm to Market 1960 West. Turn right onto Cypress Creek Parkway. Farm to Market 1960 West. Continue on Cypress Creek Parkway for 3 miles.
Aldi's, and not that I like grocery shopping or shopping in general or by myself, but I love to see what they're about.
Journalists at CNN are going to question you about it whether you like it or not.
That's right. We're here to hold their feet to the fire. And just because we are pro-Trump doesn't mean that we are anti-Trump. And, you know, as I write throughout this book and I try to close it out on a hopeful note, we are not the enemy of the people. We are defenders of the people. And we want to defend the people because we're devoted to the people.
Am I going to vote for a guy who's going to be in his 80s in his first term? And is it a reasonable question? Well, this Chris Saliza clown over at CNN said, that's crossing the line. Crossing the line. You cannot question the mental acuity of a 76 years old. So he'd be 77 next year, obviously. He'd be in his 80s. Later this year, he'd be 77. So he'd be 78. He'd be 82, I guess, at the end of his first term. And that is not a young man. And Laura played a clip of Biden himself saying, yeah, it's a valid issue. It's a valid point.
It is.
So when Fox News or anybody raises it, CNN screams, that's terrible. Can't do that. Donald Trump will run circles around Joe Biden in the stamina department. Trump is superhuman. A guy that knows they can't keep up with him. All these young staffers are scrambling to keep up with him. And the craziness. Kirsten Gillibrand comparing pro-lifers to racists. Joe Biden promising to cure cancer if he's elected president. I mean, it's just one crap storm after another. I love the clip we found from Planet of the Apes. We also got the old, this standby.
My firm belief that this country has lost its mind.
Portions of our show brought to you by Noble Gold. If you're looking for a perfect Father's Day gift.
next one.
Joint responsibility. Most cases of the type are referred to other attorneys for principal responsibility. Mesothelioma. If you know what mesothelioma is, you or someone you love has likely been affected by this devastating cancer. You may be on top of the building. I thought it was like a balloon or like one of those air balloons.
Mile, turn left and it'll drive.
Okay, the next slide. Yep, there's that little balloon.
Turn left and it'll drive.
It's like a robot or something. Boost mobile. Medical supply company. That's right.
Continue on Red Oak Drive for 3/4 mile. Your destination is on the right.
This is my doctor's office. I call him Dr. Bala, but his name's got like over 15 characters in it, so I don't even try to chop up his name. I'd like to know, but